All right, so I'm standing here with, who am I standing here with?
My name is Eric.
Okay, Eric, question for you. Why are you supporting Tulsi Gabbard?
Lots of reasons. It's so hard to pick one. I'm supporting her because she's an amazing person. I'm incredibly impressed with her and her character and her policies. For the political aspect, it's climate change, corruption, and ending wars.
I have heard that she is an advocate of some gun control. Is that accurate?
Well, for background checks, I don't know if that's gun control.
That's the only gun control she favors, changing and improving? Making more harsh, I guess?
That's not an area that I have expertise in. I think that's a wedge issue. But I think, she might want to limit, semi-automatics or some higher volume weapons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you were to vote for a candidate, which I guess you will, who does do that, limits automatics, sometimes people get killed because the government seizes their weapons or wants to seize their weapons. Would you feel any moral responsibility for the people that could be harmed as a result of such new gun laws?
This is outside of my area of competence. So the reason I support Tulsi is because issues like that are primarily congressional. And what she's focusing on is ending wars, which is what the president's, that's where they have the most amount of influence. Is domestic or foreign policy, which is domestic policy, it's not up to Tulsi whether we limit guns. That's up to Congress. And sure, she can, make that a priority or not. That's, but whether something like that happens is a congressional decision, not something a president can mandate.
Okay, fair enough. I appreciate your time, Eric. Right?
Yes, my name is Eric.
Thank you. You can continue if you want.
Oh no.
What were you going to say?
I don't know.
Oh, okay, good enough. All right, thanks. I can shout your sign. It's about 10 degrees right now.
Yeah, you were asking if I'm with the press. Yeah, it's RidleyCam.com.
That's great. Yeah.
Great. Thank you for coming out tonight.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for thanking me. Not everyone does.
I'm a strong believer of freedom of the press.
Okay. There does seem to be a degree of pro-freedom thing going on. A little bit of Ron Paul light, maybe.
Yeah, definitely.
I do have a concern about...
Can I ask, are you taking my picture?
Yeah.
For security reasons. Can you not take my picture? I'm part of the security detail. You can.
I could hold off for a while on airing it, but I'm a little reluctant to censor myself.
Okay. So don't you feel free. Okay.
Yeah.
But I don't have to smile.
Yeah, there tends to be a natural delay before I get things on the air anyway. So you'll be long
gone
from
here.
I'll
be in Vegas tomorrow, so if you want to take my picture, I'll be glad to.
Oh, you're here? Oh, I see. Yeah.
I'll be in Vegas anyway. I'm from Hawaii, so.
Okay. Oh, welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I went from 80 to 8 degrees. I'll be in
Vegas
tomorrow.
Even less locals are having some trouble with it. With regard to actual politics, a question for you. I understand she's an advocate for some gun control, is that correct? And some more than what we already have.
Well, her NRA score is a 00, but she actually is a gun owner. She served in the National Guard for Hawaii. She did 2 tours of the Middle East in places where you have to wear a flak jacket and a helmet.
But what if I want to have a firearm that she thinks I shouldn't be able to have? What does she think should happen to me? And what do you think should happen to me?
I don't understand your question.
Well, what if I don't follow her gun control if it passes? And what if I refuse to follow it? What should happen to me? What do you think should happen to me?
Me personally?
Yeah.
Well, I don't speak for the campaign, so I'm not. My comment isn't worthwhile. So there's a lot of people you could discuss this with. And like I said before, I'm just part of the security detail.
Okay, all right.
And I'm aloha. I'm from Hawaii. And I've gone from 80 degrees to 8 degrees, so it's cold here.
Okay, all right.
So my brain's already toasted.
All right. Well, I appreciate your relative transparency. I don't get that everywhere. It's Dave Ridley, RidleyReport.com.
Awesome.
It's like a poor man's TV station.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
All right. Thanks much.
Thank you. Hey, how you doing, man?
I'm audio taping.
I totally understand freedom of speech.
Right.
You know, don't have a problem with that. Okay. So forth like that.
You know, I just watched a series on
YouTube. Can you name again, sir?
Benjamin,
can you give me a second? And let me talk to someone.
It's fine.
We'll go from there, okay?
Appreciate it.
It's interesting.
Yeah. Did you heat it up or something?
No. So
a Keene police officer has come up here, and I think they may be discussing what to do with the guy with the burrito. But the burrito guy has said that he's protesting the Patriot Act by wearing his burrito. So they took a picture of his burrito. I guess I might as well take a picture of it too. The burrito is getting attention. So it looks like they're gonna let him in with his burrito. Driving in circles around Central Keene, I hurl both insults, angry and mean, against the activists from Free Keene, who wander around thinking as though they were free, and even though they aren't hurting me, I will hate them hatefully. Urging their appearance in the penitentiary, although that expense would be charged to me. I'm starting to feel somewhat confusedly.